Let's do a quick calculation. You probably know that the entries of the matrix lambda look like this. This matrix describes the frame switching from our point of view to a frame that is moving with a velocity beta. So how does this observer see us? We multiply lambda with 1, 0 and 0, 1, two vectors that represent our coordinate axes. After multiplying, 1, 0 becomes this. Gamma upwards and beta gamma to the left. The moving observer sees our time axis rotated. And what about space? 0, 1 becomes beta gamma down and gamma to the right. It's also rotated, but in the opposite direction, which is exactly how a Minkowski diagram for a motion to the left should look like. Even though the moving observer moves to the right from our point of view, he sees us moving to the left from his point of view. Let's also determine the angle between the old and new coordinate axes. We can do this simply by using the tangent function, which connects the angle to the velocity. If we perform these calculations for a variety of velocities, the points where other observers denote 1 second are all located on the same hyperbola. The reason for this is that Lorentz transformations do not change s squared, that is distances in Minkowski space. We define the length of a second as the vector t equals 1 and x equals 0. This gives s squared equals 1, and that's the equation for a hyperbola. Now for any frame with different space-time axes, we simply draw the hyperbola to know where their 1 second mark is located. The same is true for distances. We define 1 meter as the vector t equals 0 and x equals 1. Then s squared equals minus 1 and we get this hyperbola. That's pretty much it for this time. Thanks for watching and see you next week.